Hi, welcome to Ramesh Soft Video Tutorials. In this video tutorial, we will talk about the most important question: how do we validate data typing actions in Selenium? Right now, see here. So, what is data typing actions? So, data typing actions means entering some data into the text. Something like, let me show it here. So, here I'm having Facebook, right? See here. So here we are entering some data, right? 91777. So these actions we can call as about data typing actions. So here we are performing data typing actions. Really, this data is entering correctly or not. Whatever we entered this data is here entering properly or not. That I want to do validate. So here I'm entering this number. Really, this number is entered correctly or not. I want to do the validation. So how do we do this validation, right? Now see here. So this, whenever we are entering this data is going to resides as a part of one attribute. Now see here, right click, click on inspect element. So this web element is going to have one attribute. Now see here, what is the attribute I'm having? Value. And this is a what? Value. So this web element is having one attribute called value, and this value is going to hold the data whatever we are entering. So before entering the data, before we perform data typing action, this value contains the value as a null. After performing data typing action, this value contains this data whatever we entered here. So in order to get this value, which is there as a part of this web element, so in web element interface we are having one method called getAttribute method. So this getAttribute method always asks us the attribute name in the form of string. If you pass that attribute name, it returns the corresponding attribute value in the form of string. Suppose if you pass value here, it returns that value as a part of string. Now just observe here what I'm doing. Let me write a sample example so that you will understand. Now let me create one class, new class. Data typing test. Yes. Now write the main method. Now let me write a web driver. Webdriver driver is equal to new firefox driver. On this I'm calling driver dot get of https://www.facebook.com. now on this, let me identify in this page, identify this element. So she is having ID is equal to email. So driver dot find element by dot ID email. So my find element method is going to check in the DOM how many elements are having ID is equal to email. It identifies all the elements and it returns the first matching element from the node in the form of web element. Web element, email or phone. Email or phone. Now see here what I'm doing. So from this element, we need this value, right? Now see here what I'm doing. So on this element, email or phone, call get attribute. So which attribute we need? So what is the attribute here? So my attribute is value, right? So value, let me write here value. So whenever we call get attribute method on this element, I am going to get the attribute from this web element email or phone. So this email or phone web element is having value attribute. Yes, sir. Now it is going to return this value of this value attribute. Now, sir, what I am doing? Now it is get attribute method is always going to return that value in the form of string. Now let me write string phone number. Now see here, let me print SYSO before data typing actions. What is the value? Phone number. Now enter the value or phone number, email or phone dot clear, email or phone dot send keys. Now I'm writing here Ramesoft dot selenium. Now see here. So here I'm perform data typing action, right? After performing data typing action, now I want to this value. I want to have these values. Now see here. So before data typing action, the value should be null. After data typing action, now after data typing action, the value should be the entered value. Now see here. So here I didn't perform any data typing action, right? So before data typing action, the phone number should be what? Null. After I'm performing data typing action, so this value is going to hold this mail ID and it is in the form of what? String, right? Now say after data typing action, the email should be ramesoft.selenium. Let me run it. Right click, run as Java application. Now see here. Just see the output, what happens. Yes, ramesoft.selenium is entered. Now see here. So before data typing action, what is that thing is there? But after data typing action, so what is the value? Ramesoft.selenium. Now see here what I'm doing now. So let me enter, instead of email, let me enter phone number 9191777 91456. Now see here, before typing action, so before I am entering some value into this, so which is going to have what? Null. After entering something, it is going to enter that what? It is going to hold what? That value. Now see here, let me run it. Right click, run as Java application. Now see here, so before data typing action, the value should be null. After data typing action, that value should be whatever we are entering, right? So in real time, we need to do the validations. This mobile number is correct or not, this email number is correct or not, with the regular expressions. Okay, in coming videos we'll talk how do we write a dynamic functions to validate any kind of mobile numbers, any kind of email, @gmail.com, @outlook.com, anything we'll implement with the regular expressions in the coming videos in dynamic format. Now see here, I want to validate if this number is correct or not, whatever we entered, right? Now I'm taking string, I'm taking one variable, expected value is equal to, so 91777 91456. Now see here what I'm doing. Now this is my expected value. Now see here. Now if this value and this value are true, then I can say is what? Our entered data is correct. Now I'm writing if expected value dot equals ignore case or equals of equals phone number one. If both are equal, then I'm writing SYSO data typing action is done successfully and values or matching. Else SYSO of data typing action is not done and values are not matching. Now see here, let me run this program. Now see here, if this value and this value is equal, I mean this value is whatever we are entering and this value is we are getting from that application. So this is actual value, this is expected value. If both are true, then we can say that yes, whatever we entered the value, this value and that value which is holding this application, I mean we are entering some value, this value and our application which is holding the value, both are true, I mean both are matching. So our entered data is correct. Then we can say it is what? Data typing action is done successfully. Now see here, right click, run as Java application. Just observe the output, what is going to be happens. So first it launches the browser as a part of Firefox driver constructor. We have the code in such a way that it is going to pick up the Firefox binary and it launches the Firefox browser. And then URL is entered, and then in this page, in this DOM, our Selenium engine is going to identify, is there any web element which is having ID is equal to email. If so, it returns that element in the form of web element object. It doesn't mean web element, it is not creating object for web element, because we know that web element is what? Interface. So it is creating and returning web element interface implementation class object. Now see here, what is the output I got it? So before data typing action, what is the value? Nothing. After data typing action, what is the value? Whatever we entered, that value is getting or not? Yes. And this value and our expected value both are matching? Yes. Data typing action is done successfully and our values are matching. So this is the way we can validate our data typing actions in Selenium. Thanks for watching the video. Have a good day. Thank you so much.